Today, I'm talking about the Brooks Hyperion Tempo versus the Skechers Performance Razor 3. miles, 9:01 per mile, 135 beats per minute today, taking it nice and easy in the Skechers Performance Razor 3, testing it out at some slower paces so I can compare it against the Brooks Hyperion Tempo. Now, before I get to my thoughts on these two fast day shoes, I do want to go over some disclosures. I bought both of these shoes with my own money. No one sent them to me, and no one's going to be reimbursing me for my purchases, paying me to make this video or to wear any of these shoes. And in either event, no one's going to be able to preview my thoughts or see any of my footage before you guys get a chance to see this video on YouTube. Now, with the disclosures out of the way, let's talk about the Razor 3 versus the Hyperion Tempo. Now, these are two tempo day shoes that can be used for racing as well. And the reason why I would compare these two shoes is because they both use a similar type of process in making their midsoles foams, where they're infusing nitrogen into the foam molding process. It's a pretty fascinating concept, something that I'd love to be able to see in person. Now, the first shoe that I tested of these two was the Brooks Hyperion Tempo. It's a shoe that I've been running in for a little while now, and I've been really loving this shoe, especially at some of the faster paces. And because I've been loving it so much, a lot of you guys have been telling me I gotta take a look at the Razor 3, a shoe that has been out for a while and I hadn't really been looking at until very recently when Running Warehouse put this shoe for sale for 50% off. But I could see definitely why, having now run in both of these shoes, why you guys wanted me to take a look at the two of them, because there are a lot of similarities. There's a lot of differences as well. So for the Brooks Hyperion Tempo, it's made with what they're calling DNA Flash, which again is that nitrogen infused foam. There's 8 millimeters of heel drop in the shoe, a knit type of upper, a very flexible type of upper, almost like a knit-like material, and it comes in at just 7.3 ounces, so a very lightweight shoe. In comparison, the Skechers Go Run Razor 3 uses Hyperburst, which uses a similar type of technology, or if you want to get technical, I suppose since this was out on the market first, Brooks is using a similar technology as Skechers Performance. But my understanding is there's nitrogen and carbon dioxide that's used in the infusion process making this foam, which I think is what makes it look just a little bit different and behave a little bit different than the Brooks foam. And this shoe is extremely light, coming in at 6.4 ounces and has a 4 millimeter heel drop. Although I'll have to tell you, with both of these shoes, I don't really notice a difference in the heel drop. And especially with a shoe where you're going to be spending most of your time in the mid and forefoot and not really touching the heel anyway, I'm not sure that the heel drop is super important of a statistic and not really going to tell you a lot about what this shoe is really going to feel like. And so in terms of road feel, they're very similar because the foams are similar. And I think you'll definitely feel it if you run in one and then try in the other. And in terms of the way that I'd kind of split this up, I think that the Skechers Razor 3 is a little bit roomier of a shoe. I was surprised at how much space there was in the toe box. It's still a faster day shoe, a racer fit, so it's gonna be snug, but I felt like of a lot of the shoes in this category that I've been running at lately, this is probably one of the roomier examples that I felt. I also feel like it's a lot roomier in the heel cup as well, and so I felt like I had a lot of space in this part of the foot. I felt like my foot just had overall a lot of room in here. It's not that I didn't have it tied down tight. I felt very secure in the foot, but I just felt like I had a lot of room. And to go along with that, that's maybe why I feel like the shoe is a little bit more versatile. Yes, both of these shoes are really great at those tempo paces, and I was able to run in faster paces in them. But if you're running intervals, like mile repeats, or if you're running fartleks where you're playing around with some of your speed and paces, being able to have a shoe that you can also run in some of those slower speeds is helpful as well. And I think because there's more room in this shoe, and also because I think maybe the way that the Hyperburst is a little bit different in feel from the DNA Flash and the Hyperion Tempo, I feel like this Razor 3 is a little bit more versatile, and I like having it a little bit more at those slower paces. I feel like the base is a little bit wider in addition to what's going on in the heel cup, but in terms of just the landing area, in terms of how much foam there is back here, I felt like there was a little bit more cushion in the back of the shoe. So if you're doing more of a full foot strike, going from heel to toe, maybe in your recovery jog in between intervals, or you're just taking it out for an easier run like I was doing today, then I think that the Razor 3 is the better choice. Now moving on to the Hyperion Tempo, I think I overall prefer this foam a lot more. There's just a different kind of springiness to it when you're moving at faster paces that I think I prefer. The material in the upper, it's really flexible, but I still felt like I was pretty crammed into the shoe. It seems like almost like it's very narrow, a lot narrower than the Razor 3, and makes for like a longer shoe. But overall, it's a very comfortable shoe to run in. The only thing that I don't really like about this comfort-wise is the stretchy laces that they've included in this shoe for some reason. I just felt like even when I'm tying down these laces really tight, I don't feel fully secure in it. Maybe it's because this material is a little bit floppy, and I've got loose laces or stretchy laces up top. Sometimes I just feel like my foot's gonna pop right out of the shoe. It's never happened. I've never had any issues, but I always feel like I'm about to have an issue whenever I'm running in this shoe. Now, over time, that feeling's kind of gone away. So either this shoe has settled in or I've just gotten used to that feel. So it's something that's been less prominent the more miles I put in there, but it's definitely something that I noticed right away. The other thing is in the heel, I feel like this heel cup, I prefer the fit and feel of this, especially when I'm going faster than I like the fit of the Razor 3. But for those of you who do like a little bit more space, a little bit more cushion and padding in the heel cup, you might not prefer this as much. And I feel like there's really not a lot of foam going on back here. Or if they are able to play with the densities, maybe it's a little bit denser of a foam in this back area. When I'm running in recovery paces or at slower paces in the Hyperion Tempo, it just doesn't seem as happy there. And so I feel like I'm getting a lot of shock coming up through the heel whenever I'm running in this shoe. It's not painful, it's not uncomfortable, but it's not nearly as nice as when I'm running with this shoe from like the arch of the foot forward. That's where this shoe is really just special, and I really like this one. Overall, for the purpose of this shoe, when I'm comparing the Hyperion Tempo to the Razor 3 for faster days, I think I'm probably gonna be reaching for the Hyperion Tempo just a little bit more than the Razor 3. But keep in mind though, I was able to, because of this color, and I'm trying not to focus on the color of either of these two shoes for this review, this color was a 50% discounted at this point, so I got this shoe for like a little bit over $60. This shoe retails at $150, and I think it's still selling at that price. So if that's another consideration you want to take into it, I think that the two shoes are very close, and if price is the consideration, then the Razor 3 is, I think, a clear winner. But in terms of preferences, I prefer the Hyperion Tempo just a little bit more. So those are my thoughts on the Brooks Hyperion Tempo versus the Skechers Performance Razor 3. Let me know in the comments if you have any questions, or if you compared these two shoes. I'd love to talk to you guys about it more down there. That's all I have for today, everybody. Thanks so much for making it all the way to the end of the video. Hope you guys are staying safe out there when you're going running, and I will see you tomorrow. Yo, what's going on?